close from a distance. How is things going? We are taking a small bit of fight. And it takes a little bit of time.
People that are complaining and living in the United States. So if I look at all these years, you know.
So basically, like, it takes off armor, but also, like, slightly paralyzes, like, a taser gun. Yeah, it's, like, she's a defense player, so she's gonna help you, like, secure down a building or, like, even open space with her ultimate and her defense. I haven't figured out, though, that, so, like, her ultimate stops basically everybody else's ultimate, but I haven't been able to figure out if Loba can teleport into her thing or not. Need to test that in the match later.
I was kind of expecting a fairly strong performance out from Alliance. We've seen them have some fairly recent success. And maybe wasn't expecting quite such the showing that we're getting from SJP2. I think it's deserved. I think they've put in a lot of time, they've put in a lot of effort to get to this point, and it's starting to show results, but definitely was not expecting to dominate the leaderboard as much as they have been doing.
Thank you.
past 4 years at Esports Arena, we really didn't know what our identity was. We tried our pro tournaments, we tried running content pieces, we tried doing music events, we had our memberships. We realized that the community just always kept coming back for our local tournaments, for every Wednesday night, every Friday night, every Thursday night. So then it hit us. Series E is going to revolutionize the esports industry. You as a competitor now have consistency to come and compete. You get to keep coming back and let it count for something. That opportunity to get paid by Esports Arena, to get paid by a major brand that's helping support this league, this foundation, because so many times the dollars stop at the pro level. They stop there. They never trickle down to the guys like us, the guys that had the dreams, that wanted to make it, to become a pro, but never had that opportunity because they lived in somewhere in Alaska or somewhere in Idaho. No offense, Idaho. I like you guys. You're still cool. Potatoes. But when you don't have that opportunity, like a guy who's from LA or a girl who's from LA or New York or these major cities that have esports tournaments that go all the time, where can you start? Where do you go? Where do you become a pro? How can you do that? How do you get paid? How do you get noticed? How do you get recognized? It doesn't exist. There's not a clear path there. It's a randomized system. You got to be good. Don't get me wrong. You've got to be good and you got to compete. You got to play. But it's hard when you got a full-time job and you got a full-time student. You got bills to pay. You can't commit yourself 100% to esports. Esports Arena wants to change that. We are going to change that. You're going to get $1,000 a month in pay from Esports Arena. We're going to travel you across the country to compete against other people just like you. That's the feeling that I'm looking at that 8-year-old and I'm thinking, man, this person could become a professional gamer, but how? Now they're going to start their path at Esports Arena and they're going to compete to become that next pro, to become that next influencer, to become that next superstar. They're going to start at Esports Arena. That's what Series E is all about. Opportunity for everyone to be your first step in esports. We'll be right back.